fear God and keep his commandments. For this is the whole duty of a man. So now ask yourself this question. Why is it we allow other people to give us their duty? Wow. God told us the whole duty of a man. Meaning a man's charge. Yes. Of where man has been placed. His placement on the earth. His place on this earth. Why do we allow other people to give us their duty?
Yes, right. Mm. Amen. Amen.
And why are we taking on other duties that will conflict with the duty here in verse 13, chapter 12?
Yeah. Amen.
And then we get so stressed out. Amen. We're so stressed. Because we're taking on all these other duties when God said he's given us one duty.
Yes.
And through that one duty to fear God and to obey his commandments. Amen. Is the whole duty. He just didn't say duty. He said the whole duty of man. So what that mean? That means that if you imagine a tree, you see the trunk of the tree, you see the roots of that tree. The roots of that tree is the duty of man. Mm-hmm. That is the roots. That is deep down in the ground. That is like the foundation. That's what holds the tree up. Then you see the trunk come up.
Yeah.
And from out of the trunk, then you see all these branches. But as it grows up, it goes into other things.
Wow.
So when you follow the duty of a man, then it goes into your house. It goes into your decision making. It goes into your job. It goes into your spouse. It goes into your children. It goes into everywhere you place your foot. So you're just not having good ideas. But you have God ideas.
Wow.
Because that's what happens. When we have so many good ideas, they're not God ideas. And that's what is causing us to be in a place of so much pressure and stress that we begin to own that never belonged to us. Amen?
Amen.